Dhananjay Sinha, Head of Strategy and Research and Chief Economist at IDFC Securities, is joining us on the show this morning. Dhananjay, thanks very much for taking out the time. Set it up for us in terms of how you're positioned, how you're advising clients to look at their portfolios, fresh investments, rejigging of portfolios, overweights, underweights, lots of that. What's happening?
So I think there has been a certain level of pessimism in the markets. If I have heard all the investors, especially after the budget, I think the expectation from the budget was certain provision to boost the economy. The major investors I spoke to did not really carry that optimism, or at least there was a sort of failing of expectation. So there has been a certain amount of correction. So I think that is what people are looking at. My own view is that the pessimism is largely been there because of the continued slowdown in FMCG, in auto pack, etc. So there is a volume growth which has actually been lower in FMCG and a contraction as far as the auto pack is concerned. And there is a sort of a deceleration in bank credit growth. So all those things are there, which is actually things that are actually known. So whether things are worsening from what we have already heard or not is something that will be reflected in the upcoming results season. My own view is that you might actually see some kind of easing of concerns following the quarter, this quarter results. So possibly this quarter results may be somewhat less than expectation. So there might be negative surprises. So, but I think following that, I think in the following quarter, things should actually start stabilizing and possibly improve. Why I say that is because irrespective of whatever the challenges are with the numbers on the budget, there does appear to be a sort of a significant expansion as far as expenditure is concerned, roughly in the region of 28 lakhs. So that's a growth of 20% and a revenue expenditure growth of 22%. So clearly the government seem to be on the expansionary side, whether it is 20% or 18%, that will be dependent on how much tax collection they do. That is on the optimistic side, I would say. But nevertheless, there is an approach towards backfilling the contraction in spending that they did in the earlier quarter. So that is one. Number two, I would say that the government is also trying to give some help to the PSU banks by infusing more capital with 70,000 crores. And NBFCs, they are trying to instill some confidence by giving some sovereign guarantee. So there does seem to be some certain things at play. So I think that should sort of play out in the coming months. So broadly, I would say I would segment this into consumer pack and possibly that within the auto space there can be some stability there. And I am sort of bullish also, or somewhat bullish on the metal space, and I'm overweight there. So my overweights are the consumer pack. We are sort of overweight on IT. A little equal weight on the banking and financial services, some overweight on the metal pack as well. So that's broadly the portfolio weightages that we have been talking about.
You spoke about some negative surprises coming about this earnings season. I mean, while most of that is anticipated to come from the oil and gas space, specific to some stocks in the real estate space that had a high base last year, auto as a pocket. Would you say these are largely the areas where it could be more negative surprises coming in from this quarter's earnings, or there are more?
So I think broadly you have captured the areas where negative surprises might actually come in. I think, as far as the auto numbers are concerned, we all know the numbers. So I think there is a sort of a rollback of earnings that would have happened anyway. So I think that area is something that will be broadly known. There might be marginal surprises here and there, largely on the margin side. But I would say oil and gas sector, possibly yes, with a with a fall in crude prices, so that there is a possibility there of a sort of negative surprise. I would say in the NBFC space, in real estate space, I think that's where the bigger surprises will be will arise. And also, I would say, you know, if you look at the IT space, you know, HCL was a marginal negative surprise. I think if you look at the core expectation for TCS, there was expectation of 2% growth in dollar revenue. It has come out somewhat lesser at 1.6, so that has been a sort of negative surprise. We'll have to see whether that is also reflected in other IT companies or not, or is it specific to TCS. And I think within the TCS, we have seen it's largely the US geography, and within that, the BFSI space. Europe has actually done fairly well. So I think we'll have to see whether that negative surprise sort of permeates to the other major IT companies or not.
Yeah, well, that's true, Dhananjay. And one way is hoping that it doesn't percolate to the others, because it's not just TCS. Titan has sounded off a bit of a warning. HDFC Bank's numbers not looking the most impressive. But actually, that was what I was wanting to right. come to. What do you think, how would your reaction be right. to the reported numbers of the corporate-facing banks? Because they will show, because of the write-back of the provisioning, profits. But the loan growth numbers will not look strong. So how would the market, do you think, react to it? How would you react to those numbers then?
So the thing is that, we have seen a fairly strong run-up in the corporate banks over the last 6 months. And we had taken a sort of a conservative, so we were overweight earlier, and we had moved to a neutral stance in the banking space, and largely because of the run-up that we've seen and the valuation concerns that we've had. So I think that is already included in our stance. But I would say that there will be a sort of slowdown in credit growth, which is apparent, and hence possibly the earnings may actually be less than expectation, I would say, and possibly the write backs will be largely for corporate banks, specific to PSU banks who had made larger provisions earlier. So there is a positive, it's going to be a mixed thing. The corporate banks possibly gaining there, but I think the PSU banks, maybe SBI, may actually gain a little bit more, notwithstanding the lower growth in credit. So I would say that, given the valuation, we would want to be little equal weight, and then we'll see how the correction happens and then take it on after that.
All right. In fact, just to have a follow-up on that, and since you mentioned SBI, I mean, that is, one bank which has got a big bulky exposure to SR Steel. And now that, we've seen that there is some talks of lenders getting just about 60% back in the resolution case for SR Steel, that could mean a bigger haircut for SBI. Do you think that could show up in this quarter's numbers? Because they were anticipating to probably have a bigger write back for the provisions that they've made for the account.
So I would not really be able to comment on that, because these are developments that are happening. Maybe they will be able to show it in this particular quarter, and we'll see how they comment on it. But definitely that should be a factor that should be regularly tracked. So right now I would reserve my comments on that.